to care for human, and to leave the animal die behind. This is not civilization. It is darkness. From hundreds of animals, it came to be 13, the last survivor. So my name is Amir Khalil. I'm a veterinary doctor. And regarding Syria, I was the mission leader. We want to rescue 13 animals. I wake up in the morning, I find we have 14 animals. We see animals can connect people. I watched it in all the rescue missions before, in Gaza, in Mosul, in Libya, in Baghdad. I saw every soldier, whatever which his nation, whatever he believed, he just put his weapon down and he wanted to see the animal. So I noticed that animal can connect people, can build bridges between nations. Our mission in Syria is finished, but our mission to rehabilitate this animal, to offer them a better future and to care for them lifelong, it's not finished yet.
One of the birds actually tried to climb out of his new cage because he got electrocuted by the new fence. We're just taking a few steps back for our own safety, and so the animal feels a bit more calm.
Mother Teresa put it very well. She said, you know, I can't perform great miracles, but I can perform many small miracles. And that's what I've chosen to do, because nobody wanted to sponsor this daring rescue mission, Operation Noah's Ark, as they sometimes call it.
They will sacrifice their life to protect our life. I mean, I started through with the animal keeper. During the war, he was really brave enough to leave his zoo to go to buy food for animals, to care. Because this is humanity, this is hope. They cannot give up. They believe in the God. We have to protect the other species, also the human being. It's very important. But there is other species sharing this planet with us, and somebody has to care for them. And we do a small part. This animal has a story. And the story is not for this mission. It is a hope for the future, for Syrian animal, for Syrian people, a transmitter of message of humanity.